Hello everyone! Welcome to this video where we will learn about roles and profiles in Zoho CRM and how you can create them in your account. Roles in Zoho CRM helps you define the hierarchy in an organization. It allows you to permit and restrict data access for the users in your CRM account. Profiles in Zoho CRM help you define permissions to access the features in CRM for a group of users. To put it simply, roles define who you are in the organization, and profiles define what you can do in Zoho CRM. Consider Zilker Inc., an organization which is into B2B sales. John is the CEO of the organization. Susan and Olivia are sales managers. Bob, David, and George are sales representatives there. This is the short hierarchy chain of Zilker Inc. Zoho CRM offers two types of hierarchy preference for an organization: role-based hierarchy and reporting hierarchy. Let's see how Zilker Inc. exploits them. In a role-based hierarchy, John, being the CEO, will have access to all of the data owned by users below in the role hierarchy. The sales managers will have access to the data owned by the sales reps. Additionally, they can choose to share their own data with each other by using the Share Data with Peers option in the CRM. That way, Susan and Olivia can access each other's data. Bob, David, and George can only see their own data and each other's data if they choose to. So here, based on a user's role in the hierarchy, each user has access to the CRM data. But what if your organization requires users to access data based on their reporting structure? Let's say Bob and David report to Susan, and George reports to Olivia. In this case, the company does not want Susan to access George's data. Similarly, Olivia should not access Bob or David's data. Susan and Olivia cannot share their data with each other here. When the data access is defined by such a reporting structure, you can enable the reporting hierarchy. Based on your organization's need, you can choose either role-based hierarchy or reporting hierarchy. Now let's move on to profiles. Let's take the same example. Bob and David are both sales reps, and they need access to all of the modules to create, view, and edit records. But let's say George is a senior and well-performing sales rep. So, in addition to create, view, or edit records, he's given additional permission to import data which normal sales reps would not have. This is permission to access features in Zoho CRM which is different for different users. This is established using profiles in Zoho CRM. Different profiles are created for different users based on the permissions that they require. Let's see how we can reflect this in your CRM account. Go to Setup, General, Company Settings. You can select the hierarchy preference for your organization here. Here we'll select the role-based hierarchy. Now let's see how to create roles in Zoho CRM. Go to Setup, Users and Control, Security Control, Roles. By default, your organization name appears here, in this case, Zilker Inc. As you can see, by default, two roles are already available, CEO and Manager. The role CEO can be edited and the role name and description can be changed, but the role itself cannot be deleted, whereas the manager role can be deleted or edited if required. Let's create a new role for Zilker Sales Manager, who reports directly to the CEO. There are two places from where you can add a new role: using this New Role button, or by directly clicking on the plus icon to add another role in this hierarchy. Here, we name the role as Sales Manager, who reports to the CEO, which is selected here under Reports To. We have the option to share data with peers here. If there are multiple users assigned to a role, we can enable this for them so they can view each other's data. Note that this option is not available if you choose reporting hierarchy as your hierarchy preference. Next, we give a brief description of the role and hit Save. On saving, the role is created, and we see the role details here where we can edit or delete them. You can also see the list of associated users here. You can edit the role by clicking on this. Click Delete to delete the role. Note that whenever you delete a role, It's mandatory that you transfer the roles and responsibilities of that role to another role in the hierarchy. Select the role that you want to transfer the responsibilities to, and click Transfer and Delete. Now let's see how we can create profiles in Zoho CRM. By default, Zoho CRM provides two profile permissions, Administrator and Standard. Let's take a look at the Administrator profile. These are the basic permissions for modules. You can give Create, Edit, Delete, and View permissions for each module from here. Here, as you can see, the import/export permissions and other permissions below cannot be edited for the administrator profile, as these are a set of system-defined default permissions. Now, let's take a look at the standard profile. Here, also, you can edit the basic permissions, and remaining permissions are restricted like we saw in the administrator profile. However, these profiles can be cloned to create new ones, and the permissions can be edited according to your requirement. As we saw earlier, Bob is a sales rep in Zilker Inc. Few of his roles and responsibility as sales rep would include generating leads, converting leads into potential customers, email communication, managing email templates, and preparing reports by analyzing data and information. Based on this list of activities, let's define the profile permissions. He will not need an administrator profile, so we can clone the standard profile in Zoho CRM and create a new profile. Select New Profile here. Let's name this profile Sales Rep. Here, choose the profile that you want to clone, Standard. Give a description of the profile here. Bob needs access to all modules, so in the basic permissions he's given, View, Create, and Edit permissions for all modules. Let's uncheck Delete permission because to delete data, he needs the approval of his manager. Bob definitely needs the permission to send emails, so we enable all the send email permissions. Additionally, we enable the permissions to convert, mass convert, share records, and emails and templates. It's ideal that Bob, being a sales rep, cannot have admin level permissions that allow him to create new users in the CRM, among others. So, all of these permissions are disabled for him. The changes made are saved automatically. Here we go. We've created a new profile for Bob based on his roles and responsibilities. New profiles can be created accordingly, and necessary permissions can be given to the users. As you can see, when we click on a particular profile, we have the option to clone the profile from here. By selecting View Users, we can see the users that are associated with that profile. You can rename the new profiles here by clicking on this ellipses symbol and selecting Rename. Enter the new name and click Save. Thus, you can create roles and profiles for your business accordingly. Thank you for watching this video. For more resources on Zoho CRM, please visit www.zoho.com/crm/resources.